Behind this work. All these paintings are presenting Miss Leslie Wages. She's my godmother and second mother to me. I'm inspired by her because she was a woman who had the opportunity to travel the world and model and meet new people and just experience life. And then as she grew older, she grew up and got married and had her son, Ron. And about 2 years ago, she was incarcerated, and it was very difficult for me to deal with because she's like a best friend to me. And I had to use how I felt work to make myself feel better. And so with this new work, I basically tried to bring her past and her present together. And at first it was because I was upset and depressed and feeling lonely. I just turned 21. And I had my mother, I don't know what she's at, right there. And I had this second mother, and it was very difficult for me. And so I basically just tried to bridge a gap between her past and her present. And it started off really sad. But when I went to go see her and I talked to her, she said, "Sophia, don't feel sorry. I feel more free here than I've ever felt in my whole life." She said, "I've been waking up, I've been meditating, I've been praying." She said, "I want every night before you go to sleep for you to picture me walking out these doors." And I've always known that our minds are a powerful thing. Mm-hmm. And for her to know that and to be free where she's at, no matter what her situation is, meant so much to me. And it just told me that wherever you currently at does not have to be where you're at up here. Oh, up here is more important. Yeah. And I've just been really inspired by God to move forward and make this work and to do something that meant something to me. I've always just been painting. I've always been painting for other people. It felt so good to do something for myself. And I know that this will be so much to her. And I miss her so much. And this is so good. She said, "Keep me alive on the other side." So that's what I'm trying to do. And I'm glad that you all were here to experience that with me. And she's okay, she's happy, she's blessed, and she knows that, and that's the most important thing. And I think in all the pieces, especially when my eyes opened and today just came out, and I don't really know where it came from, but it was something that came very naturally. And it's just her eyes are one thing that never changed, no matter what she was going through or where she was at. She, I always could look into her eyes and feel completely comfortable, so maybe that's what came out in the scene.
Wow. Beautiful.
Any other questions?
And this one.
The same question.
It's kind of like when one surrenders oneself, when one finally lets go of their self and lets God take control.
I see in this one you call it like the Marilyn Monroe type of sexy feeling that.
Because this was the first painting I've ever done of her. I did this for her husband for Christmas. Mm-hmm. So, that was when I was just very infatuated. She has, all I have of her is this portfolio. It's about this thick. Mm-hmm. And it's these photographs from when she used to model in the 80s from Europe and Japan. And I felt like I had to put those pictures to you.
So were these all painted from photographs or from life or from your memory or
mostly photographs? Actually, all of that. This is the largest painting I've ever done, so I really have to put my all into it. Mm-hmm. And I feel like it's just, it shows to come from where point A, where everything started, it was like a big collapse. So right now, where we can stand up and talk about it and know with confidence and be proud of her. I feel like that was something I needed to share with other people.
Much better, like in real life.